Hello friends, welcome back to this video on analog communication. In this video, we are going to discuss the power in wideband frequency modulation. So, the frequency modulated signal MT was given by, I have already discussed, so it was AC summation n is equal to minus infinity to infinity Jn beta cos of omega c plus n omega n t. So this represents my modulated signal. So now if I expand this, how I can represent? So the modulated signal mt is equal to ac j naught beta cos of omega c t plus, so here I put n is equal to 0, so ac j minus 1 beta cos of omega c minus omega m t. So now here I put n is equal to minus 1 plus ac j of 1 beta cos of, here what would be omega c, plus 1 into omega m, which is omega m into t, plus ac, now I'll put n is equal to minus 2, j minus 2 beta cos of omega c minus 2 omega m into t, plus ac j 2 beta cos of omega c plus here 2 omega m into t. So now here I can expand these side bands up to infinity. So up to infinity and up to minus infinity I have infinite side bands. So now I express these in the spectral domain as well. So now if I talk about this term, so what would be the power content here? So this is the amplitude, because J naught beta is a real term, it's an integer. So J naught beta into AC, it would be a number. So it is multiplied by cos omega CT. So if I need to find out the power of this term, so it would be AC square J naught square beta upon 2 into R. So R, I am taking R is equal to 1 from the first power calculation only. So it is my P naught T. So this is my power of this carrier. So now this does not contain any information. You can see the frequency I have just the carrier frequency. So here the message content is not there. So this is my power of carrier in the modulated signal. So if I talk about the modulated signal, this term gives me the power of the carrier in the modulated signal, because this term does not contain any message information. So now if I talk about the first lower sideband, so the power of first lower sideband would be equal to, so now here this is my amplitude, this is the cos term. So the power would be AC square J minus 1 beta square upon 2. So I hope you all are agreeing with me. Similarly, if I find out power of first upper sideband, so the upper sideband is denoted by this term. So its power would be AC square J1 beta square upon 2. I hope now you are agreeing with me. So the power of second sideband, so if I talk about the power of second lower sideband, so it would be equal to, now what it is, AC square J minus 2 beta square upon 2. Now we'll see the power of second upper sideband. So power of second upper sideband is equal to AC square, so it can be concluded from that term. So it is J2 beta square upon 2. So now This is how I can find out the power of all of the sideband. So if I see any sideband, here the frequency is changing according to M. Here also the frequency is changing according to M. Here also frequency is changing according to M. So all of the sidebands are containing the information of the message signal. So let's take the total power. So now if I add all of the powers, so the total power is represented by summation of all of these terms. So AC square J naught square beta upon 2 plus AC square J1 square beta upon 2 plus AC square J minus 1 beta square upon 2 plus AC square J2 square beta upon 2 plus AC square J minus 2 square beta upon 2 plus so on. So now this is my total power. So now if I have to simplify it, what I can do, I can take AC square by 2 common. So here I am left out with J naught square beta plus J1 square beta plus J minus 1 square beta plus J2 square beta plus J minus 2 square beta and so on. So now if I have to represent all of these Bessel functions, how I can represent them? It is AC square by 2 summation n is equal to minus infinity to infinity Jn square beta. So now in my previous video when I was discussing about the properties of the Bessel function, I represented this was equal to 1. So now total power is equal to AC square upon 2. So now what was my carrier signal? So the carrier signal, so CT was AC cos of omega CT. So if I talk about the power of the carrier, so the power of the carrier is AC square by 2. So now from here we deduce that in FM we require the same power which was before modulation. So before modulation the power was AC square by 2 and after modulation again the power is AC square upon 2. But now if I check the power at the carrier frequency component, the power would be different. So here at the carrier frequency component, I'll write it. So now in the modulated signal, which term represents the carrier frequency component? So this term is having the lower frequency than carrier, higher frequency than carrier, lower frequency than carrier. So every time we'll be having higher or lower frequency than carrier, but only this term contains the carrier frequency component. So at carrier frequency component, the power of the carrier, so I am denoting it with PC dash, it is equal to AC square J naught beta square upon 2. So now this power is redundant because it is not transmitting any information of my message signal. It is just the carrier power in the modulated signal. So now if I reduce this component to 0, so now whenever this power is reduced to 0, that time I'll get 100% efficiency, because the efficiency is power of the sideband upon the power of the total power. So the total power was equal to the power of carrier plus the power of sideband. So now if I talk about the power of sidebands, all of the components except the first term represents the sideband. So the power of carrier is represented by this term. So whenever this term is zero, so upper side we have PSB and at the denominator we have PSB. So at that time when PC is equal to 0, so it is PC dash. So when it is 0, that time we'll get 100% efficiency. So at the 100% efficiency, the value of beta at 100% efficiency is called its eigenvalue. So if I need to find out the eigenvalue of beta, I'll see the 100% efficiency, the value of the beta at the 100% efficiency will give me the eigenvalue of beta. So now if I talk about this term, so this term, when it would be 0, I'll get 100% efficiency, that is sure. So when J naught beta is equal to 0, because AC is a constant, 2 is a constant, these can't be 0, only J naught beta can be 0. And the Bessel function has the graph which is like this. So now the value of J naught beta are 0 at beta is equal to 0. So at these values of beta, the Bessel function is 0. When the Bessel function is 0, this full term will be 0. When this full term is 0, I'll be having power of sideband upon the power of sideband, because this is 0. So because this component's power now will become 0. So these components' power are 0 at 2.4 beta, 5.5 beta, 11.8 beta. So now from here we deduce that the standard modulation index for the best efficiency, so the efficiency is 100%, which was for VSB, double sideband suppressed carrier, and single sideband suppressed carrier as well. So now if I need to find it efficient similar to the double sideband suppressed carrier, single sideband suppressed carrier and VSB, so that time I'll choose the modulation index equal to these numbers. So then only I'll be having the 100% efficiency. So here I'll be stopping my discussion. If you still have any doubt in any of the part which I discussed here, you can put the doubt in the comment and I'll try to resolve it as soon as possible. I hope you like this video. If you like it, share it with your friends, subscribe the channel and push the like button. Thank you.